Howdy folks, I'm Keith Bowen, this is Hard Rock University, and today Eva and I are exploring. There's a mine right there, a pretty significant size, and we're coming down a clearly manufactured trail. You can see they've dug into that side and filled that side, and we've got a pretty good idea of where this goes. And it might provide a useful access. But for right now, we're just exploring and seeing if we see anything interesting. Okay, so that trail didn't really lead anywhere except a bunch of downed trees, etc. I know where it goes, but it's not a very useful trail, so no big deal. Here we are at the dozer dump, a disturbed area, and it's Eva's feeling, and I tend to concur, that for some obscure reason, this layer of the dump has a lot more quartz than this coarser material. So you see that line across there? What we're going to do is we're going to take this down in slices and sort each slice as we go. All the waste rock will go over the edge. And we will stockpile buckets of quartz over there and get a better idea of what's going on. So, let's get to work. Okay, so we've taken the biomat off. And in sorting through it, there's very little rock. Almost all the actual rocks are quartz.
And it should be noted that these are the kind of crystal clusters that I typically find. It should also be noted, even though I didn't find any this time, the smallest intact crystal clusters I find are in that biomat.
Now, we're operating on the hypothesis that the freeze-thaw cycles in the winter have literally crushed the upper layer, and then the roots have kind of fed on the stuff and decomposed it further. So you have this real fine material here and roots with just the occasional quartz in it, the quartz being residual because it just doesn't weather as well. That's our hypothesis at the moment.
As a matter of fact, if you take a look down here, this is quartz, crystals, quartz, and quartz.
I understand, but it's out of the zone we're dealing with.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying that was there when the biomat that we were working with caved down.
So, now we're going to take the next layer and just, you know, like 4 to 6 inches and see what happens. Now we've taken off another layer. Just brought it down here. And don't get a much clearer thing than that of how...
Oh man, and the crystal broke off this as I picked it up.
Yeah, well,
look.
Be careful. And now we're getting a bunch of these. Do we even find any decent crystal clusters in the last
Not this
layer?
Size.
Yeah.
As I said, the micro ones are in the biomat. The larger ones are in just below what I call the interface zone between the dirt part of the biomat and where the roots are. And that one, unfortunately...
This is a piece of quartz here. More quartz. See how much larger they are. And there's how the surface looks directly under the biomat.
Notice the thick roots.
Yeah, these roots really chewing on this stuff.
See, there's another.
So that's another piece of quartz vein. This would be a little veinlet that was in the host rock originally. Now it looks like the host rock is completely weathered away from it.
Yeah, and you can see here the veins are still actively eating the host rock, and there is quartz
in the roots.
There's actual quartz veins in this host rock that will be left behind. It is my belief that the guy's like this with a flat back.
Yeah, that's where the host rock was there.
Yeah, this was a toothy dude at one point in his life.
Yep. So anyhow,
this one here,
we're going to continue to sort through. There's your the void still left in the middle. Here's where your host rock was, and this is the deposit of quartz on that side of the crack. So, anyhow, time for us to sort it a little better, and all the waste is just going bye-bye, so all you'll see is the quartz left over. Okay.
This is that big guy broken up. As you can see, he's all sugar quartz inside, which the fancy word, I guess, is saccharoidal. In another 100 years, he probably would have been mostly picked to just down to that.
Yep. Anyhow, we're trying to figure out what happens, because it seems like down there, there ain't much. The question is, why? Okay, now we're getting another layer down. We break down. And so far, that is all the quartz we found in the soil. This was the quartz we found underneath the soil, and those are the crystal clusters. This one is the next 6 inches. See, only half the quartz. And in that area, we found a very good example of what Eva likes to call toothy dudes. But this used to be a fracture in the rock between my thumb and my forefinger that was filled with quartz, and it just didn't quite have time to fill up before the solution stopped for whatever reason. But anyhow, that shows you the process and where you get these quartz clusters from. Now this next layer show different textures. There's a little crystal cluster in there.
That's one of the skeletonized dudes.
But this bladed structure here, we've been told by people who know more than we do, means it's in the upper end of an epithermal hydrothermal system. In other words, one close to the surface where it's actually boiling. And that comes from the interaction with calcite. And what you can't see is that this is actually fairly light. This is not some of the best stuff in general. This is not what we're really looking for. But all of this came out of that little section right there. Go figure. Okay, now, here's one of the things that's kind of hard to figure out. That rock came from right there. Bust up. It's almost all quartz. There's some calcite. You can see the veining, or the layering rather. And so this is what we call massive quartz. We assume that's ore. And we're going to bust that into something that'll go in the crusher a little easier. But you can see the size of the rocks is getting bigger as we get down lower in that thing. We also, a bias that we're getting is that as I dig that out, finer material goes down into the cracks between the larger ones. So stuff from above is actually migrating and integrating beneath it. So we shall see, but when you get rocks like that versus rocks like this, it makes a difference.
See, I just busted a different face on them so you can see the layering in the host rock as opposed to the layering with the calcite and then the quartz on this side.
So, anyhow, continue on.
Really nice.
Okay, we sorted that layer now. That one rock pretty much took up a whole bucket. This is another bucket of smaller stuff, and we did get a few crystal clusters out of this, but not many. Okay, now we're down to the original surface. That's that kind of black stuff. It's the original leaf litter. It's decomposed. And I really don't see a huge amount of difference in terms of quartz from wear. But you can see different types. So this is the bottommost layer. And then we got kind of the mid stuff. Then we got the boiling zone material. And then we'll go the upper. So we'll label these separately and process them, or at least the initial processing separately. And that'll give us an idea whether there's some particular layer. Now the way a dozer works is the stuff on the bottom was what he pushed first, as a general rule. And then later on, more and more layers on top as he gets deeper up there. So if there's a dramatic difference in the amount of gold in these various samples, that may give us an idea whether it's getting better or worse and whether digging deeper might be a bright idea or not. Also, Eva, whose eyes are much better than mine right now, says that that Mullock pile right there has a lot of quartz in it. So we may do some sampling there, because presumably, right over there, presumably that Mullock pile came from this trench. So if there's any quartz there, it came from right in there. So we're going to go test that out too this afternoon, get some samples there. Try and come up with a load by the end of the day or first thing in the morning, and then call it a trip. Okay, so we've made a little progress over here. Off to the right, there's an Eva for scale.
Hi, everybody.
Now, this is interesting. We've got what looks like a Mullock heap here from this trench that was theoretically dug here. And then we got the dozer push there. And when we look, it's almost like three different kinds of materials. Here you got large blocks with big holes in them, consistent with a dozer pushing big material, you know, just ripping and snorting.
You can see there's some quartz in there.
This has some quartz in it. Then we've got this zone here, which has, I would guess, of the rocks themselves, about 50% quartz. Then we come over here. It's a finer grain material, consistent with hand digging, but there's very little quartz in this stuff here. And we got typical biomat on the top.
There have not been very many crystal clusters here either.
Yep. I'm going to take a bucket of that finer material there to see what it runs, and then underneath this, I don't know, it's kind of hard to see here. Here, why don't you hold that while I take the sample. That way it will be able to show what I'm talking about here.
It's an unlabeled bucket.
I know. You have to label it. And then underneath it, that looks like the original surface, or at least an original surface. You can see there's organics and stuff there. And this is gray, fine-grained material.
Yeah, the color does not, probably not show very well on the video, but it's an almost ash gray.
Yeah, so my guess is this is decomposing bedrock or something else and it underlays that over there too. So this may be the original altered zone that they were kind of chasing. I don't know, but we're taking a sample of that too.
Oh, absolutely. The more buckets, the better.
And then we'll just crush them all up and process them and see what happens.
Oh, I don't think we're going to be crushing up the dirt, but okay.
Yeah, we crush the dirt. It runs through the RC46. Just okay. Put the rolls in. Feed it slowly.
Just please don't put it in our tank.
Yeah. And we'll see what happens. Happy prospecting and keep it safe out there.